As you learn how to cook, you will probably hear phrases like, eggs keep cooking on the plate, or let a steak rise 5 degrees as it rests, and think to yourself, there is no way that a steak can go from medium well to well done in 5 minutes off of the heat. That's because not enough lip service is paid to the underlying act of momentum. If you're cooking French-style scrambled eggs on extremely low heat, there isn't much momentum behind the cooking process. A gentle heat keeps the temperature rising slowly, so once you plate it up, it's not going to solidify much further. A hard, hot scramble on an American diner's flat top, however, may bubble up immediately, catch a big wave of heat, and then keep getting hotter even after it comes off. You have to think about how high the heat is and how much mass it's cooking. If you cook a burger outdoors on a cold, windy day, you can bet your beef will stop rising in temperature soon after it's removed from the heat source. The hot grill gets the momentum going, but a cold wind can stop it quickly. Say you've got vegetables cooking for a few seconds in a rolling boil of salted water. After you get the food to its target temperature, it's good practice to plunge it into an ice bath to stop the momentum. This is called blanching, and if you skipped the ice bath, you'd get the overcooked, mushy vegetables that we tend to associate with parentally mandated consumption quotas. If you spend 12 hours holding a 15-pound brisket at exactly 225 degrees in a smoker, that heat sinking hunk of meat is gonna stay hot for a long time. Something that massive is extremely resistant to change. Just ask Drake, whose sheer size has prevented any sort of growth, change, or evolution since Views. Where a measly little steak benefits from a minutes-long rest, brisket gets hours. You'll sometimes see pitmasters chuck a whole cooked packer into a Yeti. That's because it's gonna take so long to come off of that 225 cruise control momentum that it can easily stay warm as it rests. You can come back 8 hours later and the meat'll still be steaming hot. Keep momentum in mind, not just while cooking, but also when plating. Are your plates room temp or hot out the dishwasher? If I spend all the money and effort to purchase good fish, keep it ice cold, and eat it raw, you can bet that I'm serving it on a plate that's been iced out in the freezer for an hour. I'm not gonna let some 80 degree ambient temps ruin my crudo gnashing experience. Momentum is the idea behind the reverse sear. A normal restaurant style steak gets seared over an extremely high flame, then placed into an oven to come up to temp. A reverse sear cooks in the oven first, then the pan. It makes sense since the hot air of an oven transfers energy at a much slower rate than direct contact with ripping hot iron. Since the oven temp is so low, the momentum is low too, so your window of perfect doneness opportunity is much wider, a matter of minutes instead of seconds. You can get the steak close to its target temp, then sear it to carry it through the finish line. Don't let yourself go too crazy trying to exercise omnipotent power over momentum. You can cook a ribeye to precisely 135 sous vide, then plunge it into pure liquid nitrogen to halt the momentum entirely, and then deep fry the whole thing under extreme heat, allowing dense hot oil to make direct contact with every millimeter of the food's surface. But the old I cook, you clean compact that you might have with your dinner guests is getting revoked, redacted, nullified, and immolated by anyone who has to tidy up the kitchen before bed after that. Wield this power responsibly. Trade has paid to be mentioned at the end of this video. Trade is a service that ships coffee from local coffee roasters all across the country straight to your door. First, you take a quiz regarding how you prepare and enjoy your coffee. Then, you pick a delivery frequency that works for you. I get a new bag every 3 weeks, so I never run out, and the coffee's always perfectly fresh because it's roasted right before it ships out, in a compostable bag, no less. Then, after you've tasted it, you rate each coffee so the recommendations get even better over time. I have this friend named Louisiana who called me last week after buying a new mocha pot asking for coffee tips. She was spending a considerable amount on regular grocery store coffee, but she didn't like the lack of flavor that was found after trying the cheaper coffee options in the aisle. I personally told her to try Trade. The prices are fair, and the coffee actually tastes good since it's selected for your specific brew method and it's freshly roasted. Trade guarantees that you will love your first coffee. If you don't, they will ship you a different bag for free. Speaking of free coffee, your first bag is free when you sign up. Take the quiz by clicking the link in the description, and the shipping will be free too.